It's a very special day for Star Cinema's managing director, Inang Olivia Lamasan. The acclaimed director is celebrating her birthday. In celebration of that, here are some of the many words of wisdom from our beloved Inang.
You know, my dad would always say, rolling stones gather no moss on. Have the patience to plant your seeds. Sabi niya, because nothing in life is easy. Work is always hard. But that's it. I mean, success doesn't come easy to anyone. Sabi niya, you work hard. Kasi by some twist of fate, napunta ako sa pagsusulat dahil ayaw ng director kong i-shoot yung eksena na hindi siya nagagandahan sa script. And so, kailangan i-revise ng writer. Yung writer naman, ayaw nang mag-revise kasi meron na siyang iba mga tanggap na projects. So, para lang matuloy ang shooting, ang ginawa ko, hindi ko pinalam sa director na ako ang nag-revise. Nagustuhan niya. So, that was how I started writing, by revising the words of another writer. So, yun. So, until one project, yung Kapang Langit na Kumato, na-discover ako ni Luis Gillian that I could write. And so after that project, she asked me to write a full-length movie for her in Viva, under Viva Films. Ito yung ipagpatawad mo no, ni Vilma Santos and Boyet de Leon. So that was my first full screenplay, and it won in the Urian and Star Awards. So that was the beginnings of my career as a writer. But out of necessity, naging director ako kasi nung ginagawa naman namin yung Maalaala Mo Kaya TV, at nung nagbukas yung Star Cinema, nakita namin na may problema that parang we were under the mercy of the schedule of the senior directors who were really very busy at that time. And so Charo and Malu said, it's about time that we, you know, build our own pool of creatives, writers and directors. So sabi ni Charo, o sige, simulan natin yan sa'yo. So that was when I was given a break to direct Maalaala Mo Kaya TV, which I did for about a year. And then after that, they gave me the break to do film. You know, my first movie was Maalaala Mo Kaya, the movie. So that was how I became a director. Because we did not have really much, always, I lived by the principle that giving up is not an option. I have to be able to finish whatever it is that I committed myself to do. So I will resign after, but never truly. Because I tried, a couple of times that I tried resigning during, and my boss, Charo Santos Concho, would just say, cry it out, or crying is good for the soul. And then I would always remember how my mom would work so hard to raise us and give us the best education. And I would say, oh, giving up is not an option. I will have to see through what I committed myself to do.
So this year, we are celebrating the 20th year of San Mauro. This is my second movie as a director. I was one. I was 32 years old, no? At the time, so... Hindi naman. Oh, tama. 32 years old at the time. Although it was my second, it was a movie of firsts. It was the first time that Star Cinema did a movie abroad. It was also the first time where, at the time, hindi namin naisip, but we realized it eventually that ito pala ang unang OFW ng Star Cinema. And then, it was also my first time to direct a love story. And it was the first time for me to work with the Adamula and the Lea Salonga. Dalawang tao na talagang nire-respect ko at hinahangaan ko. Not only for their contributions to the entertainment industry, pero most especially dahil sa pagkatao. Sa totoo lang po, first time kong makarating ng Amerika. So wala akong alam, kaalam-alam sa polong buhay ng mga tao. So anyway, sabi niya, hindi ba rin eh, ang pag-asa na lang natin, pag hindi magustuhan ng Aga at saka na Lea yung script, then we can tell siya, oh, ah, tayo mo din buka ko to the Philippines. I'll never forget the day that I first met Lea Salonga. She flew in from New York. Remember that? Yeah. And then, so Manu and I said, I'll ask her, so, what did you think of the script? Ang sinabi niya, oh my God, it is awesome. So, tingin na kami ng Manu, atay. So, sabi ko, di ba na yung chance na natin si Aga? So, Aga flew in from the Philippines and sabi niya, wow! Ang ganda ng script!
Ang dami mo tinawag na anak. Ay, para sa staff, anak. So, anak, anak.
Kaya tinawag akong mami. Yun naman ang una sa sharing ko nito show. Mami, mami. Tapos, merong isa na parang sabi, provinsyano ako, hindi kita matawag mami. Pwede ba inam na lang? Sabi ko, oh, Eddie, kung ano gusto mo itawag sa akin, Oli.
Si Tagan po ba ito? Hindi nang mami.
Si Kelly.
Ate Kelly Aguilo.
Tapos yun na. Naging inam na for the longest time. So, yun, okay naman. Kasi talagang, kung nakalimutan ko, anak, anak. Guwacha, pati ganyan. Hanggang sabi, naloka na ako, pati si Charo, talata, pati si Gabo Lopez, inalasta. Ang nasa iyo na talaga yung naging moniker. Pagbata ka, okay lang. At 52, ayoko nang tinatawag na inang. Pero, it stopped. So, I'm here and I live with it.
Once again, join us in greeting Inang a happy, happy birthday. Happy birthday, Inang, from your Star Cinema family.